snow plowing time. So it's been a while. We haven't really had any snowfall for about, I don't know, 2 weeks. Yeah, the last major snowfall was when I put out the last video. So now we've got, I think, maybe 10 centimeters or something like that. It's been snowing 24 hours, very nice, mellow snowfall. So let's go out and do some snow plowing. So we have had some really cold days, not like the last or the first cold days of the year, but minus 30 something couple of days. Now we're getting warmer weather, and then we're starting to see snowfall. Got it like that. This time we're not forgetting to put the coupler lock in or out, or yeah. I almost lost the plow in the last video. That's not a tragedy, but I would probably have ripped the hoses off or something like that, so I'm glad I caught it. Let's see here. Ah. So just a video. So we're going down plowing the road, and I will finish up plowing, fixing the around the houses. But we will go down this way today. went out to move the post box, but I didn't move the
trash can.
Yeah, we'll fix that on the way back. Perspective. I think it's almost 300 new subscribers, or maybe more now. So I'm really, really happy about that, and I hope that this video is to your liking. Back up and try to push the banks a bit further out. It's supposed to be a possibility to meet up in this curve. is me forcing the gearbox to first gear. Second gear, it skips first gear. I don't know why, but it's just how the gearbox works on these machines. So if you want to have first gear, you need to push the gear selector to enable first gear, and then it locks on first gear. It doesn't shift up, I think. I don't know. Yeah. So let's go outwards. This down with the bucket. to go. Time to go up and snowplow from the house and workshop and maybe not back down the ditch into the ditch. Let's try that instead. This was backwards. I usually go down this the first thing I do, but today I wanted to mix it up. And this is backwards, really backwards, but this is unscripted, and sometimes thinking while doing stuff isn't working for me. I bet there's some of you out there that can relate to that. But anyway, between releasing the previous video and this video, I passed the 1,000 mark on subscribers, and that meant that I qualified to the YouTube Partner Program. So that was, I was really happy about that. Now I'm still really happy about that. That's, for me, that's an achievement. And there's been a lot of subscribers off that. I think the latest number I saw was 1270 or 1271. So I don't know what to say. I'm thank you. It's really nice to feel that the work behind making these videos are appreciated. So I hope you like this one as well. I've been busy with my other business endeavors, opening up a location, office, a new office location, and employing some really nice and professional guys to work with me. In my engineering firm. So that's been taking a lot of my time, and there hasn't been any snow really, so I think it's about 2 weeks since the last video came out, maybe a couple of days more. I have some videos that's going to be edited from different projects, but I really haven't had the time to edit those. But I'm working on it. So there will be more videos. There will be more plowing videos as well. I have a plowing video that I haven't released, and I'm not sure really why I never released it, but being out of time might have been one reason. So I might release that one. It's probably the last. Plowing I will do with the big plow. If you paid attention, it was standing here in the darkness. I think it feels ashamed of itself. No, not really. But I've taken some photos and I'm going to put it out for sale, but haven't really gotten to that yet. So I haven't gotten to that either. It's a lot of small stuff that has been not time critical, so to speak. So I haven't done them in order to get all the stuff finished for the new office space. But now we're up and running, so that feels really, really nice. So maybe in a week or two I will put out an ad for that plow and see what we can get from that. I've been scouting for a nice old fixed V plow, these old older, mostly 60s 70s, maybe some of them are from the 80s, truck plows that have been rebuilt for the wheel loader, the ISO coupler, or I don't know, maybe I'll find one that's not rebuilt yet. That's okay as well. But I've seen some interesting plows, and hopefully we can invest in one. The most interesting one has been far, far away, and since I'm kind of out of time right now, I don't want to go that far to get one. I would like to get the symmetrical one. I've seen some that are asymmetrical and have a wider right side, but I would like to find one that could work with the side wing or could work with a modified version of the side wing, but those asymmetrical ones that has the wider right side, I think those goes away, because I don't think that will work with the side wing. I need to flip the wires for this electrical switch on the third function. It's counterintuitive. You flip the switch to the left, and that activates the side wing. Then you flip it to the right, it activates the front wing. I think about this every time I run this, that I need to fix it, because I'm always switching it the wrong way. And from the beginning I thought, yeah, I'll learn that, no problem, but I mean, now we're a year later and I haven't learned that. And then I did it again. again, if you're still here and new to the channel, there's a build video of this side wing. It's about a year ago. Check it out if you want to see how I built it, or just like workshop projects in general. There's a couple of other videos like that as well. I rebuilt my hydraulic press, thinking that YouTube likes hydraulic presses. No, I needed to rebuild it, but so there's a video about that. There's some videos about me using my rusted out old Yanmar excavator, repairing that, and also a video series about me building a trailer for the excavator. And as a little spoiler for you who are still watching, the excavator isn't really feeling so good anymore, and there will be a video about that as well. But it kind of decided to decided that it didn't want to it bled out, so to speak, and if you have seen the videos, I think you can guess what caused it. Yeah, I think that will be good enough for today. Maybe we'll just take away some more snow here so we can go in and get the trailer later. Somebody has put a pole here. Huh. Yeah, there's poles and stuff. Because there's some ongoing training here for a driver's license. It's not me. I have all the letters on my driver's license that's necessary, at least in my opinion. So, let's unhook this one and call it a night. take down the banks or the snow piles, so you get a better, you get better sight when you're going out. Let's see what we can do. Put the beacon on. This ditch is quite deep and quite steep, so I really don't want to go down. I don't think I will get up, but I think that's better, even though it's not perfect, but we'll have better visibility to the lower car. So